Well, it's an age-old problem. Younger generations entering the workforce and making it harder for anyone older and more experienced to get a job. But tonight we meet some of Australia's hardest working seniors, given a second chance by their forward-thinking employers as they retake their place in the business world. Here's 6.30's Emily Rice.
Fiorina Basso has always enjoyed hard work, especially as a farmer's wife 60 years ago.
We started a dairy farm, and to me there was no satisfaction because I was a silent worker and didn't get paid for it.
So she sought her own wage through sewing, and the 81-year-old has been working solidly since her teens. Her latest career move is to a brand new business.
How's it going?
Have you got a new sample there, have you?
Yeah, I was thinking maybe you could just close some of it off.
Linda Vidra sources old materials to recycle into a range of sustainable handbags. The young designer came across some vintage work skills at a Melbourne lawn bowls club, employing Fiorina and other seniors for their sewing expertise.
I wanted to create a cross-generational initiative, so something where you can have the younger and the older generations coming together, and the older generation kind of have that really beautiful craftsmanship and the real attention to detail, and it works really well together.
Yeah, we can always teach, and they can teach us. My mother used to say, you're never too old to learn.
Linda believes the history behind her locally produced purses will appeal to customers.
I think it's really important to not go overseas to China, and you lose that personal feel to the products.
And she won't lose this seamstress to retirement.
Never. I said to my husband, I'm going to die standing up.
Scientist Ray Davidson has been retired for 6 years and is back at school.
You have to dig down, dig way down underneath and lift it up.
He's sharing his science and gardening knowledge with students 60 years his junior through national volunteer organisation Time Help.
The school gets to a little bit of expertise that to me is now not being used because I'm not working, and the heavy lifting in the garden.
Australia's first age discrimination commissioner, Susan Ryan, applauds those seeking out older workers, but says seniors are still sidelined by many employers.
A lot of service people still think it's okay, that once you're in your 50s, you're over the hill and you shouldn't be taken seriously. Well, that's what I'm passionate about changing.
Former psychologist Ruth Lord adores helping students read and write at Altona Primary School in Melbourne.
Great! Do you know what? How many did you get right?
The 85-year-old says whether work is paid or volunteered, it's important for her generation to have a purpose.
Absolutely critical. And so many studies have shown how important it is to health, just physical health.
Older workers are also very reliable employees and volunteers. Their rates of absenteeism are low, and they're 5 times less likely to change jobs than their younger counterparts. And with Australia's shrinking labour force, our senior citizens will be crucial to fill the gaps.
It's helped me to belong, and from belonging I can move on and feel happier.
Emily Rice reporting there.